this will be trail day 86. It's Wednesday, September 16th of 2020. We stayed here at the Full Goose shelter, which is right there. There's a couple of tent platforms, and I hung my hammock over this one between the furthest tree and that tree there. It is right at 9:30, and I'm almost packed up ready to leave. Got up at 7:30, had some strawberries and cream oatmeal and French vanilla cappuccino, so raring to go now. It says it's 50 degrees. I got down in the 30s last night, but stayed nice and warm. So here in a mile, I think we got to climb a mountain first, and then we'll be in the Mahoosuc Notch, known as the longest mile on the AT. So we'll see what kind of boulder playground we got ahead of us for today. So this is the Full Goose shelter. Not much to it. The bear box. The privy's right there. The big group platform site right that way. And the AT goes right by it. It's 5.1 miles to the Speck Pond campsite. I may go there. Just depends on how it goes today. I'd like to get at least 10 miles, but I'm not gonna rush it in this first part of Maine. Just go with the flow. We have to climb 433 feet and then we descend down into the Mahoosuc Notch. And the squirrels are already fussing. Not a bad view. The climb up here wasn't so bad, but now we get to descend into the notch. So it just came down there. Not so bad, and this is the trail the way I'm going. So far the descent down to the Mahoosuc Notch is fairly mellow. No challenge. I was sort of surprised the shelter last night. Everybody that was at the shelter the night before was there. So they didn't push on through. We just did a 9 mile day as well. They just got there earlier. So they didn't get there too late. Got there at 9. Cooked dinner. Went to bed around 11. Woke up at like 6:45, but didn't get up until like 7:15. But we should be getting to the good stuff here shortly. So this is the first challenge, going down into the Mahoosuc Notch. I usually just walk down these, but this one's a little on the steep side, so I'll go down it like a ladder. And then there's more right over there. Not too bad. That'd probably be impossible in the rain without them steel bars. But the jungle gym is beginning. Well, here we are, the west end of the Mahoosuc Notch. The climb down was not too horrible. A few boulders, but definitely nothing hadn't seen already. I didn't figure there would be, but I checked. Nope, no cell service. The worst parts of the trail seem to not have any service. It's cold right here in this spot. All these rocks and moss kind of get that Christmas tree aroma. We'll be at the good stuff momentarily. But here we go. This is the beginning. For some strange reason, I have Axl Rose in the back of my head singing the song, "Welcome to the Jungle, We Got Fun and Games." Go ahead and put my trekking poles away. Not so bad so far. But we've just began, so. It's definitely a boulder crawl. So I got back out one trekking pole. Kind of hard to follow the trail in places. Looks like people's going that way and people's going that way. I don't see any blaze. I heard it's kind of a pick your own way through in spots. Yeah, it looked like a better way than that way over there. I could definitely tell people it went through over there, but there's a blaze. I don't know if that's where we're going to go underground or I gotta go over that. I gotta get down there first. A little bitty bird. It kind of looks like there's an opening over there, but I think that's a smidge of a blaze on that rock. So we had a little short section. It wasn't boulders. It was just like typical trail. And now we're back to the boulders. There's a blaze there and a blaze over there. Trying to figure out which way to go. There's a blaze on a rock there. And I can see where a bunch of people went that way. And there's a trail that, but those sticks are piled up. Like, don't go that way. So I want you to go down this way. Of course they would want you to go this way. Yeah, there's a blaze and an arrow. Although the arrows are quite faded. Instead of bringing some sticks to pile up, they should bring some paint with them. Refresh the directions. No arrows or nothing. It looks like people's gone that way. And people are going this way. Wonder how many people's gone that way. Unintentionally, of course. Well, looks like this is the right way. Yep, there's a blade. I can't tell if that's the way it's supposed to go or not. I don't think so. It'd be hard pressed to squeeze through that without a pack. Well, it looks like plenty of people's went up. Looks like it's taming out a little bit for a minute. The camera scared it away. Little bitty mouse. Look how he was running up through there. He was coming back down, but then when the camera made the noise, he turned around and ran off. But just this little bitty teeny brown mouse. Oh, we're back to climbing over boulders. Sounds like water running. It is water running. Yep, water. Which I don't need any, but I saw several comments on gut hooks about water in the notch. But either gut hooks or AWOL listed that there was water in the notch. There's probably a massive cave underneath. Yeah, there's more water running there. One day the earth will open and all these rocks will just disappear. All because of that little water trickle. You can just hear it pouring. Don't see it, but you can hear it. It's flowing out and pouring over there. There's a big hole somewhere. Probably some super cold water. Let's see if we can make this work. Good thing that wasn't like one of those deep. This is going to be more fun than a barrel of monkeys. Well, to go through there, in my case, I definitely have to take my pack off. Because me and my pack are just too big.